Hello everyone, welcome to the Java course. We know that we can make use of the public keyword to declare the instance variables. So let me show you an example, and let me show you the problem with this kind of declaration. My computer objects would have an instance variable called memory size in gigabyte. A computer also has a storage size in terabytes. Okay, I'm now going to set up the constructor for my computer class. Here, I just pass the values obtained from the formal parameter list to set up the instance variable content. And then I can go to the driver class, which is regarded as an external class to the computer class. And in the driver class, I can do something like this. I set up the reference variable to a potential computer object. I call the variable name laptop. Here I create a computer object with memory of 16 gigabytes and storage of 1.5 terabytes. And in the driver class, we can actually access the instance variables directly. I can print the instance variable out. After printing the memory size out, I can even change the content of the memory size instance variable. So let me run it. Okay. I can print out the instance variable directly, and I can also change the instance variable. So when I print it out again, the value would become 32, which is another value coming from my new assignment performed in the driver class, which is regarded as an outside class to the computer class. So that kind of arrangement can be quite dangerous for the objects created from other classes. Imagine you are having a bank account class. You don't want others to change the salary for a certain customer, or you don't want other people to change the bank balance of a certain customer. And you don't want others to simply access the driver class and do these kinds of operations to change the customer information, or even just take a look at the customer information. We don't want others to do so directly to protect the information. So how can we improve the security of the data in separate objects? We can make use of the private keyword. So when we go back to the computer class, I just need to change the instance variable declaration from public to private. Let me save it. In doing so, the instance variables pertaining to a certain object is no longer visible by other outside classes. Here, I can't take a look at the instance variable. Also, I can't make changes to the instance variables directly. So when I run it, I will have some errors. When I proceed, it will see that the instance variables are not visible. So that is a way to protect the data from the objects. So if we really want to change or take a look at the contents of the object instance variables, how can I do that? We can create some accessors or mutators in the computer class so that we make use of the methods from the computer classes to take a look at the data and change the data. So how can I do that? I can go back to the computer class. Okay, I set up a method called getMemory. So the driver class can call the method which returns the integer value representing the memory size of a certain computer object. And it is known as accessor or getter method. So I can do the same thing for the storage size. The storage size is a double instance variable, so I change the return type of the getStorage method to double. Okay, these are the two methods that allow the driver class to get the contents of a certain instance object. Okay, how can I change the content of an object? I can create some mutators or setter methods. This is the setMemory method from the computer class. By calling the setMemory method, I can change the memory size instance variable to a value passed to the setMemory method by this simple assignment. Since memory size is a private instance variable, only the computer class can directly access the instance variables. And also I use the return type to be void because I don't need to give out a value coming from the setMemory method. I just want to change the content of an instance variable. I can do the same thing for the storage size instance variable. Okay, this is the set storage method, so that when I use this method, I can change the storage capacity of a computer object to a value passed to it. So now I can go back to the driver class. So for now, I can't make use of the direct exit approach to take a look at the instance variables or even change the instance variables. What will I do instead? If I want to change the storage size, I can make use of this set storage method shown here. By calling the set storage method, I can change the laptop to 2 terabytes of storage. When I call the getStorage method, I can go back to the computer class and look for this getStorage method. In the getStorage method, we would return the storage size, which is actually an instance variable for a laptop object. So let me try them now. Save it. Run it. Okay, the set storage method has already changed the instance variable of the laptop object from 1.5 terabyte to 2 terabytes. And the get storage method pertaining to the computer object allows us to access the newly assigned value of the storage, which is now 2.0 terabytes. Since we make the instance variable private, we can't access them directly. We have to make use of the accessor here and the mutators here to change the contents of the instance variables of a certain object. So in this case, the user of the driver class can only make use of the methods provided by the computer class to make some changes. And in this case, the computer class has full control of the way to set or change the contents. In this case, external classes can have no way to do the changes on their own. The users have to rely on the methods provided by the computer class to do these changes. So the contents of the accessors and mutators can be made secret to the users of the driver class. In this case, the creator of the computer class can hide the implementation of the setup of the mutators and the accessor methods. How can the producer of the computer class to hide the source code of the accessors and the mutators? It's quite easy. The creator of the computer class can simply transfer the computer.java the generator of this source code can simply give the bytecode of the computer .java class to the other users that would make use of the computer classes. So the programmer who writes the driver program can have no idea of what you are going to do with the methods. What the driver programmer knows is the bytecode, which is non-understandable by the programmer. So in this case, the implementation of the methods can be made secret to the other users of the computer class. So this is the reason for using the private instance variables instead of using the public instance variables. If you use the public versions of the declaration, other people can simply change the content for your objects. But now, when I use the private keyword, I have to provide the accessors and mutators for other programmers of the driver class to do the changes to the object information. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.